Yo guys, what is going on? Mortex here. It's been a while, I know it has. I've been sorting the new house out, but we are finally all settled in and set up. So I wanted to do a quick video today to show you how to get the PS2 working on RetroArch. So without further ado, let's crack on. So the first thing you want to do is go to these two websites I'm going to show you on the system. The first one is going to be RetroArch, so you need to download this. I would highly recommend downloading the 64-bit. And next we're going to go onto PCSX2. Now we're going to go to download and Windows. There's two different variations. You can get the standalone or the binary. We don't want the standalone, we want the binary because it gives us all the files that we need. So download that, put it on the system where you normally install it, extract it, and then we'll be good to go. So as you can see here, I've already extracted all mine ready to go. And I've also got the BIOS files as well. Once installed and all up and running, the first thing we are going to do is go onto RetroArch and get this set up. So you want to double click RetroArch so it launches. And then once you do this, we want to download the PS2 emulator. So we're going to go onto online updater. And then we're going to go onto core downloader. Now this will fetch every single core that RetroArch has to offer. Scroll down and you will find the PS2 emulator. Just remember guys, this is still in alpha at the moment. So we click on that and it downloads it. I've already got it downloaded. Then we're going to go back onto the main screen. What we're going to do now is we're actually going to install the PSX2. That's a bit of a strange one because we have to install the standalone emulator to get the files that we need. So you can see them all here. There is some files missing. So what we're going to do is install it first. So we open it up, press next, next, let it do its magic. Now this is where you can actually install the bio files. There is a folder there, so we're just going to drag and drop it into the folder. It just makes things a lot easier. So you can press finish now, press OK, click off it, and you can see the folder has generated a lot more files, and that's what we need. Now we're into the BIOS again, so all we're going to do is drag and drop them. Now you can find these on the internet, so we're going to cut and paste this straight into the BIOS. Now once that's done, we are done with the emulator. We can just close that down. Now once we are done with the bio files, what we actually need to do is drag the full folder into RetroArch. When you installed RetroArch, it would have made a system file somewhere on your system. Mine's in the C drive, and as you can see, it's in RetroArch 64. Now to install this emulator, we need to go to System. And as you can see, I've already got a folder there. I'll just delete that really quickly. And then what we will do is drag this file in. And we're pretty much good to go. Then we go back into RetroArch. And then all we're going to do is we're going to load the core, which we've downloaded, which is the PCSX2 core. We do that, and then we're going to load some content. So we go into where the ROMs are, so we go into user, desktop, and then ROMs, and then we'll click a PS2 game. Let's go for, I don't know, let's go for Scarface. Now, if you run into this problem, you've done what a lot of people do and you've put a folder within a folder. So what we need to do, go back into RetroArch 64 and go into System. As you can see here, when we put the PS2 folder in the binary folder, it was actually in a subfolder. And if that is the case, RetroArch will not recognize any of the files. So all you need to do is drag all these files out of the subfolder and put them into the main folder. But the only reason why this didn't work is because it was in a subfolder. So remember to put it in the main folder, because if you have it integrated into a subfolder, it will not work. Now one thing I've got to remind you, this is still an alpha guys. Some of the games on it I've tested don't run. The majority of PS2 games do run, but some don't. Prime example is going to be what I'm going to show you now, Scarface. For some reason I just couldn't get it to work no matter what. So I'll show you this right now. So we click it up and then it loads, but we just get a white screen of nothing and then it crashes. I believe this is due to the build being in alpha, so it should improve in time. So what I'm going to show you now is Warriors on the PS2 loading up, and then I'll show you how to change the settings so you can get some nice 4K if that's really what you want. So I'm using the PC, so once it's loaded up we press F1 and then we get into the main menu. Now this menu is where we're able to change all the display settings and a couple more settings as well. You can do it at standard definition, but I think why would you want to do that? We're in the 21st century. Let's get it up to 4K. And what we're going to do now, I'm just going to relaunch the game and you'll be able to see the dramatic difference. So that's it guys, that's a really quick video on how you can get the PCSX2 running in RetroArch. It's a nice alternative so you don't have to use a standalone and everything is together all in one. Just remember this is still in alpha, so it's going to have quite a lot of bugs, so if you do run into them, as I say, please be patient. But as always guys, if you did like this kind of content, please give me the thumbs up. We've got various other content down below. But until next time guys, stay safe and I'll see you all soon.